بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. We continue the explanation of the 40 Nawawi collection of hadith, and we have reached hadith number 37 عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يرويه عن ربه تبارك وتعالى أنه قال: إن الله كتب الحسنات والسيئات ثم بين ذلك، فمن هم بحسنة فلم يعملها كتبها الله عنده حسنة كاملة، وإن هم بها فعملها كتبها الله عنده 10 حسنات إلى 700 ضعف إلى أضعاف كثيرة، وإن هم بسيئة فلم يعملها كتبها الله عنده حسنة كاملة، وإن هم بها فعملها كتبها الله سيئة واحدة. رواه البخاري ومسلم في صحيحيهما بهذه الحروف. The explanation of this hadith. Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما relates that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, among the sayings he relates from his Lord is: Allah has written written down the good deeds and the bad deeds. Then he explained it, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم بين ذلك. Then he explained it by saying. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the correction. If somebody intends to do a good deed and he does not do it, Allah writes it down with himself as a full. Good deed, meaning in his account with Allah. And if he intends to do a good deed and actually did it, then Allah will write for him in his account with him its reward equal from 10 to 700 times to many more times over. And if somebody intended a bad deed and has not done it, Allah writes it down with him as a full good deed. But if he has intended it and has done it, Allah writes it down as one bad deed. And this is related by Bukhari and Muslim in their two sahihs. Okay, here in the beginning, Ibn Abbas said that the Prophet ﷺ said, in that which he relates of that of which he relates from his Rabb, meaning that this hadith is Qudsi. This is a Qudsi hadith. This is the hadith which the Prophet ﷺ relates from his Rabb. In this, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ الْحَسَنَاتِ والسيئات ثم بين ذلك. الله سبحانه وتعالى has written the good deeds and the bad deeds, and he explained that, meaning he wrote their occurrence and he wrote their reward in terms of the good deeds, and also he wrote the occurrence of the bad deeds and he wrote their punishments. So, and since he wrote them, then they are to occur in accordance with his pre-decree, which he wrote in the preserved tablet. So it's written their occurrence in the preserved tablet, and the reward is as indicated by the Sharia. Then he explained that detail. So whoever, if somebody intends to do a good deed and he does not do it, then Allah will write for him a full good deed in his account with him. Full. Here, this does not refer to the mere self-talk. Because the mere self-talk is not written for nor against the person. What is intended here, the determination to do, the determination to do, however, it is followed by laziness and the person does not do it. So Allah will write it for him a full reward, a full reward. Now if someone says, how is it that he is rewarded while he didn't do that which he intended? The answer is, he is rewarded for the determination. He is rewarded for the determination and with the good intention. So it is written for him a full good deed. It is written for him a full good deed. And one should know that the intending of doing the good deed, intending to do a good deed and not doing it, has three angles to it. Has three angles to it. The first angle, he takes by the means, but does not attain the doing of this good deed. Under such a situation, his reward will be full. His reward will be full reward. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, chapter 4, verse 100, وَمَنْ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ مُهَاجِرًا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ يُدْرِكْهُ الْمَوْتُ فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. He who emigrates from his home in cause of Allah will find on earth many dwelling places and plenty to live by. This is evidence. Similarly, the person walks his way to the masjid, to the mosque, intending to pray the obligatory prayer in the mosque, intending to pray it standing. Then he arrives and then finds himself incapable to pray the obligatory prayer in a standing position. In this case, he will receive the full reward as if he prayed standing, because he took the means needed to accomplish this deed, but he was not able to attain it. You understand the first angle? Is the first angle clear? Now, the evidence is there in the ayah, and he who emigrates from his home in the cause of Allah will find on earth many dwelling places and plenty to live with. So he takes by the means, but he may not attain it. And whoever leaves his home as an immigrant unto Allah and his messenger, and death overtakes him, his reward is then surely incumbent upon Allah. And also with respect to the person who takes by the means, walks his way to the masjid to establish the salah, an obligatory salah, to establish it as required, standing. Then when he arrives, he becomes incapable of standing, and rather he sits. In this case, he will have the reward as if he is standing. Why? Because he took the means to accomplish this work, but he was not able to attain it. Is that clear? Okay. The second angle. The person intends, the Muslim or the person intends to do the good deed and makes the determination. Listen, he intends and makes the determination upon it. However, he abandons it for a better deed. He abandons it for the sake of a better deed. In this case, he will be rewarded. The reward of the higher deed or the better deed, and also he will be rewarded for his intention of the lesser good one. Of the lesser good one. The evidence for this. You understand the overall, you understand this this angle. He will be rewarded for the intention for the lesser, but he will be also rewarded for the one which he what? For the better. For the better. The evidence for this, a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam after the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam opened Mecca. This man came to him and he said, O Messenger of Allah, I made a vow that if Allah opens Mecca for you, that I will pray in Baytul Maqdis in Jerusalem. The Prophet ﷺ told him, Salliha huna, pray right here. So he repeated twice. The Prophet ﷺ said the second time, Salliha huna, pray here. And the third, he insisted. So the Prophet ﷺ, Sha'nuka idhan, it's up to you. You see, in this case, there is a transformation from the lesser to the higher, which is better. You understand? So he directed him for what? For which one? For the better, which is Mecca, right? Which is higher. Yes. Now, the third angle. If he intends the good deed, but he abandons it out of laziness. Like, for example, a person intends to perform the two rak'ah of duha. Then someone comes to his house, knocks the door and says, let's go take a walk. So he leaves the salah and accompanies this man in a walk. In this case, this person will be rewarded for his first intent, for his initial intent and his initial determination but he's not going to be rewarded for the action because he did not do the action and he did not leave it because of an excuse, and also because he did not abandon it for something which is better. You understand? So he's not going to be rewarded for the action. He's not going to be rewarded for the action. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَإِنْ هَمَّ بِهَا فَعَمَلَهَا أو فَعَمِلَهَا كَتَبَهَا اللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ عَشْرَ حَسَنَةً. But if he has intended it and has done it, Allah writes it down with himself as 10, as 10 good deeds. Walhamdulillah. And the evidence for this in the Quran is the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-An'am chapter 6 verse 160, من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها ومن جاء بالسيئة فلا يجزى إلا مثلها وهم لا يظلمون. من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها ومن جاء بالسيئة فلا يجزى إلا مثلها وهم لا يظلمون. Whoever brings a good deed shall have 10 times the like thereof to his credit, and whoever brings an evil deed shall have only the recompense of the like thereof, and they will not be wronged. So Allah will write this with him, 10 good deeds. Allah made this incumbent upon himself and promised, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who fulfills his promise. Up to 700 times this falls under the mashi'ah, the will of Allah. If he wishes, he will increase it to this level, and if he doesn't, then he will not. 10 good deeds to 700 times, or many times over, meaning more than 700. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, وَإِنْ هَمَّ بِسَيِّئَةٍ فَلَمْ يَعْمَلْهَا كَتَبَهَا اللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ حَسَنَةً كَامِلَةً. وَإِنْ هَمَّ بِسَيِّئَةٍ. Now if he intends to do a bad deed but does not do it, then Allah will write it with himself for him in his account, حسنة كاملة, full reward. And in the hadith it came, لأنه إنما تركها من جرائي, that is because he left it for my sake. So that's why it is written for him, full deed, because he left it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake. Now there are cases with respect, or angles with respect to intending to do the bad deed. Intending to do the bad deed. The first is the person intends to do the bad deed and makes the determination in his heart. Not just mere talk of the self, no. Then afterwards, he checks himself and then abandons it for Allah Azza wa Jal, most mighty and most majestic. This is the one who will receive the full good deed. This is the one who will receive the full good deed. Why? Because he left it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he did not do it. No. Why? So that it is not done, it's not written against him as a bad deed. This is the first situation, or the first angle. The second one, the person intends the bad deed and makes the determination upon it. But he becomes incapable to act accordingly without seeking the means, without seeking the means for it. Like the man whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about. This man said, I wish I have the like of the wealth of such and such, so that I will do like him. And that man had wealth, but he was a spendthrifter on himself. So in this case, this is written as a bad deed. However, this is not like the doer of the deed, of the bad deed. This is written for him as a sin because of his intention. An intention of the sin. I'm sorry, the sin for his intention. As came in the hadith, فَهُوَ بِنِيَّتِهِ. His situation is in accordance with his intention. And so they are all sinful equally, as came in the narration, on equal footing with respect to the intention. So therefore here it will be written for him as a bad deed, but not like the doer. Why? Because he didn't he wished, but he didn't. You understand? He wished, huh? Because he wished, but he did not act upon it. You see the difference between the two? He did not do it, but he said, I wish I have like this other person's wealth, the same as his. The third situation, the person intends the bad deed and seeks to accomplish it, but he fails because of incapability or being unable. Here what? It will be what? Full what? Written for him full. Full as what? Full bad, what? You tell me. Full bad deed. You see the difference now? Why? What's the difference? What's the difference between the third and the second, which we just mentioned? Why? What's the difference? No, he didn't act. He did not act. He sought to act. He would have done it if he could. He sought to accomplish it. He intended, not only intended, and he sought, but he wasn't able due to circumstances exactly. What's the evidence for this? The evidence is in the hadith, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا الْتَقَى الْمُسْلِمَانِ بِسَيْفَيْهِمَا فَالْقَاتِلُ وَالْمَقْتُولُ فِي النَّارِ. قال يا رسول الله هذا القاتل فما بال المقتول؟ لماذا يكون في النار؟ قال لأنه كان حريصا على قتل صاحبه فكتب عليه عقوبة القاتل. In this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, if two Muslims meet each other with their swords, then both the killer and the killed one are in the hellfire. I said, the narrator, I said, O Allah's Messenger, it is all right for the killer. It is all right for the killer. But what about the killed one? What about the killed one? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the killed one was eager to kill his opponent. The killed one was eager to kill his opponent. You understand? Okay, طيب. Another example, an example. If someone prepares himself, makes the intention, and takes the means to rob a house, and then he brings the ladder to climb over the fence, but for some reason he wasn't able. He saw a man coming or something, you know, he fell. Here he will have what? The full bad deed of a thief, right? He full bad deed of what? Of the thief. Judged by his doing. Now it's obvious. Not only that he intended and made the determination, but he took by the means. So he'll be held accountable as a thief. Ma'am, you understand? He brought the ladder. He brought the ladder and put it on the fence. Naam. طيب. Fourth situation. The person makes the intention to do a bad deed. Then he relinquish that, not for Allah's sake, and not for inability. Not for Allah's sake, nor for inability. In this case, there is nothing upon him and nothing for him. Nothing upon him and nothing for him. And this occurs a lot. The person intends to do the bad deed, then he abandons that. But he didn't abandon it for the sake of Allah. So therefore, he is not rewarded because he did not leave it for the sake of Allah. And he is not punishable because he didn't do that which entails the punishment. You understand this fourth one? طيب. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وَإِنْ هَمَّ بِهَا فَعَمِلَهَا كَتَبَهَا اللَّهُ سَيِّئَةً وَاحِدًا. And so if he intends to do it and does it, Allah will write it for him one سيئة. Listen, he said سيئة and underline one سيئة واحدة, one bad deed. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about himself in Surah Al-An'am, subhanahu wa ta'ala, chapter 6, verse 54, كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. الحمد لله. كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. Your Lord has written mercy for himself. Has written mercy for himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the Qudsi hadith, inna rahmati sabaqat ghadabi, my mercy preceded my anger. My mercy preceded my anger. This is evident because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards on the good deeds. And also, this is evident in terms of the recompense on the bad deeds. The Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah said, "Unzur ya akhi, look, O brother, وَفَقَنَ اللَّهُ وَإِيَّاكَ إِلَىٰ عَظِيمِ لُطْفِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ." May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who gain the clemency of Allah the Most High. He said, وَتَأَمَّلْ هَذِهِ الْأَلْفَاظِ وَتَأَمَّلْ هَذِهِ الْأَلْفَاظِ and contemplate these wordings. When he said, عِنْدَهُ with him, this indicates his care subhanahu wa ta'ala for it, for the good deed. And he's saying kamila, full, asserting his good care. While in the case of the bad deed, where the person intended to do it, then relinquished that, Allah said, كَتَبَهَا اللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ حَسَنَةً كَامِلَةً. He wrote that for him in his account with Allah, full, kamila. You see? كاملة, complete, full. However, if he does it, he writes it for him one bad deed. This asserts what? He did not say one. Listen, he did not say one full deed. You see the difference? He did not say one full bad deed, right? But with the good deed, he said what? With the good deed, he said, full good. You see the difference? Full good deed. Here, he said the minimal. Because it's minimum. One qalila, light. One bad, asserted. One bad, one, only one. You see the difference? Full good deed. Here, one, just one. He asserted that it is what? Just one. He did not assert it by saying full bad deed. You see the difference between the two? Instead he said one bad, just one. You see that? فَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ وَالْمِنَّةِ. To Allah is all praise and favor. سُبْحَانَهُ لَا نُحْصِي ثَنَاءً عَلَيْهِ. The one free of all imperfection. We cannot enumerate praising him. وَبِاللَّهِ التَّوْفِيقِ. The difference between the full bad deed and one bad deed. He asserted the good one. Listen, he asserted the good one with full. While he asserted the bad with what? With what? With what? With one. Just one. Because his mercy precedes his anger. Subhanahu wa ta'ala and his wrath. And Allah, your Lord, wrote upon himself mercy, wrote mercy upon himself. This is, as our Shaykh rahimahullah commented on Imam al-Nawawi's comment here, he said, وَهَذَا تَعْلِيقٌ طَيِّبٌ مِنَ الْمُؤَلِّفِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ. And this is a good comment from the author, meaning Imam al-Nawawi, may Allah's mercy be upon him. From the benefits of this hadith, the narration of the Prophet والسلام, relating of his Lord in the Qudsi narrations. Is this from the word of Allah Azza wa Jal, word and meaning, text and meaning, or is it the speech of Allah, the word of Allah in meaning, while the text is from the messenger? The people of hadith differed on this on two accounts, and the safe thing is for us not to go in deep concerning this matter, rather to say the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in that which he relates from his Lord such and such, and this is sufficient. And we talked about this in detail in a previous discussion on one of the narrations in the same book of Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah. The second benefit, affirming the writing of the good and the bad deeds in occurrence and in reward and in punishment. Third, the occurring, that which will occur from the good and the bad, is written and is established, is written and is established, and it is inevitable to occur and take place. And in this, there is no plea for the sinner to go and sin, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him sight and understanding and hearing, and sent for him the messengers and made the truth clear for him. In addition, he does not know of what is written for him already. So how then could he dare and say, I have a plea? And how could then he dare and indulge in sins and say, they are written upon me, preordained upon me? Why doesn't he go and act upon the good deeds and say the same thing, they are preordained for me? So therefore, there is no plea for the sinner for his sin, because of two proofs: a textual proof and an intellectual proof. The textual proof is that when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told the companions, ما منكم من أحد إلا كتب مقعده من الجنة والنار, none of you except that his place in paradise and his place in hell has been already written. They said, O Messenger of Allah, shouldn't we relinquish deeds and doing, acting, and just depend upon what is written, what is already written? He said, no. He alayhi salatu wasalam said, no. لا اعملوا فكل ميسر لما خلق له. Rather, act for each one or everyone will have that made easy for him. What was created, he was created for, will made easy for him. The people of happiness, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from them, then they will proceed to do the acts of the people of happiness and made easy for them. And as to the people of wickedness, then the work of the people of wickedness will be made easy for them. Then he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recited as evidence and as attestation for what he said, he recited the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Layl, verses 5 to 10. Surah Al-Layl, verses 5 to 10. 92, 5 to 10. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. As for him who gives in charity and keeps his duty to Allah and fears him and believes in al-husna, all good things, in good, including the tawheed and everything, we will make smooth for him the path of ease, of goodness. وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. But he who is greedy, miser, and thinks himself self-sufficient and gives the lie to al-husna, we will make smooth for him the path for evil. So this is a textual proof whereby the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded to disconnect oneself from reliance upon what is written in the pre-decree, and instead to act. اعملوا, act. As to the intellectual proof, then it will be said to this man, who informed you that Allah has written already for you that you are a sinner? Do you know before your action? Do you know that before your action? His answer should be obvious. No one knows. No. We, because all of us don't know that which is already pre-decreed, except that after its occurrence. And therefore, there is no textual nor intellectual pretext for the sinner to use. The fourth benefit, affirming the actions to Allah Azza wa Jal, because Allah said كَتَبَ, wrote. Whether we say that Allah commanded the writing or he wrote himself. And Ahlul Sunnah are Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah are on the creed that the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal are attributes of the self inseparable from him, and attributes of actions that are in accordance with his will. He does as he wills. The fifth benefit, the care of Allah Azza wa Jal concerning the creation, where he has written their deeds, the good and the bad, universally and legally. From the benefits of this hadith, you remember in the beginning, and then he explained. So there was a generalization followed by explanation. And this is from eloquency, that you bring first a general wording of your point, then you detail it. Why? Because when you mention the thing in general terms, the self will become eager, waiting for the explanation of this which is generalized. So you bring the details and the clarification upon a self so much eager to and ready, So therefore, the matter falls upon the self and becomes asserted and affirmed. So this is from the eloquency. Also from the benefits of this hadith is the merit, the favor of Allah Azza wa Jal, His clemency and His goodness, that the person who intends to do the good deed but does not do it, Allah will write it for him, a full deed, when he makes the determination. And again, we're not talking about just mere self-talk, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardoned us on the self-talk. It is not against us nor for us. And we discussed earlier the several angles to this matter. The eighth benefit is the amplification of reward, and that in principle the good deed is rewarded tenfold, and it may increase to 700 and to many more. The amplification of the reward for good deeds may be relevant to the time, to the place, to the action, and to the doer. Again, relevant to the amplification, relevant or related to the time, the timing, the place, the action, and the doer. As to the timing, example. As to the timing, example. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said concerning the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma min ayyamin al-amal as-salih fihin ahabbu ila Allah min hadhihi al-ayyam al-ashr." No good deed or no good deeds done on other days are superior to those done on these, meaning the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. They said, not even the jihad in Allah's cause. He said, "Wala al-jihad fi sabilillah," not even the jihad for Allah's cause. And therefore, this is a reward, magnification of reward. What? In relation to what? In relation to what? Asking you. In relation to time. Yes, the timing. Second, and also from that is the saying of Allah concerning the night of the pre-decree, the night of decree. In Surah Al-Qadr. قال الله تعالى ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. And the night of decree is better than 1,000 months. Second, with respect to المكان, time, the place, sorry. It is affirmed from the Prophet ﷺ that he had said, "Salatun fi masjidi hadha afdalu min alf salatin fi ma siwah illa masjid al-Ka'bah." The prayer in my masjid, meaning the Prophet's masjid, is better than 1,000 salah in other than the masjid, his masjid, except masjid al-Ka'bah, the masjid of the Ka'bah in Mecca. So this is with respect to what? The magnitude of reward with respect to what? The place. Now, the third is with respect to the action itself. The action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said إن في حديث القدسي ما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضت إليه. My slave would not be nearer to me than in that which is beloved to me more than which I had made obligatory upon him. So therefore, the action which is obligatory is better than the action which is, you tell me. The action which is obligatory is better than the action which is voluntary, optional. Naam. So therefore, here there is amplification with respect to the action. طيب. The fourth, with respect to the doer. With respect to the doer. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا تسبوا أصحابي. Do not abuse my companions. فوالذي نفسي بيده لو أنفق أحدكم مثل أحد ذهبا ما بلغ مد أحدكم ولا نصيفه. مد أحدكم أو ولا نصيفه. Don't abuse my companions, for if any one of you spent gold equal to Uhud, Mount Uhud, meaning in Allah's cause, it wouldn't be equal to a mud. It wouldn't be equal to a mud or even half the mud, which is a measure, spent by one of them. One of them of whom? Referring to whom? The companions. Yes. Don't abuse my companions. And here, while we were talking to you now, you can see on the screen, someone popped in and he is saying, when there is a war on Islam, let's just hope that there is a room where we can all sit and quote understand Islam. This is the name of our room now, understand Islam. We have no duty to work together politically or economically for the benefits of humanity of all Muslims. Please don't get me wrong, I just use the name as a metaphor. The room does have a purpose, but it cannot afford to ignore politics if we really want to understand Islam in all of its forms. Now, here, this is a vivid example. The Prophet ﷺ is saying, don't abuse my companions. Now we're going to see what the politics has done to this person, may Allah guide him, who came to this room and posted this and left. Don't abuse my companions. This room, which they want to have there in some other place, wants to talk about the politics of what's going on between the Rafida and the Jewish state. This hadith came, subhanallah, on time. Don't abuse my companions. Now, see what politics does to people. You see what politics does to people. These Rafida consider the companions all as kafirs, except for 3 and 4. And because of politics, we have to cover and accept and ignore for the sake of politics and games. This is ignorance of the real path that brings victory, is to understand the deen and understand Islam properly. So therefore, these are some of the angles, or the four angles, where the magnitude of the reward is amplified in terms of time, in terms of time, in terms of place, in terms of action, and in terms of the doer. Also, the actions excel each other depending upon the level of ikhlas, of sincerity. We have three people. We have three people. Someone intended in his action to ascribe to the command of Allah and seek means of nearness to him. And another, the second person, intended his action is to fulfill the obligation. And it could be like just a norm, while the third intended a kind of show-off or something for this worldly life. Who is the most perfect amongst them? Who is the most perfect amongst the three? The first or the second or the third? The first one. The first one. And that's why when we perform the worship, we should make presence and contemplate the command of Allah, then also make presence the following of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in the worship, so that we attain the ikhlas, the sincerity, and the following. And the ninth benefit is that whoever intends to do the evil or the wrong or the bad deed and does not do that, Allah will write it for him as a full account of reward, and we detailed the meaning earlier. But if he does it and acts upon it, it will be done only just one bad deed. However, it should be known that the sins are two types, major and minor. Similarly, the good deeds, some of them are obligations, some are voluntary, and each will have its own ruling and its proper and due reward. And all success is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whom I ask to accept this effort and to make it sincere for his face and to make it count for me on the good scale on the day of resurrection, and for you too. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.